center in a preschool classroom, or one of the most important centers in the preschool classroom, is anything that has a lot of manipulatives. Music, science center, table toys, and anything fine motor like Legos, Wiki Sticks, and Play-Doh. So we're going to start here. We're going to start with our music center. Our music center is small but mighty. We have everything labeled, again, picture and word, and we have it organized in see-through bins. That this way students know exactly what they need and they can easily access it. It's near the loud centers, so you're not going to be bothered. And it's see-through bins. I know I'm looking for this instrument. I know it's in this drawer. I know I'm looking for these instruments. They're here. It's super easy to keep students engaged and able to organize when you label. My biggest advice, label everything. I'm gonna put this back. Next to the music center, and one of our biggest centers is table toys or manipulatives. Our manipulatives take up space everywhere, in the cubbies, in the shelves, and above them. We start with a scale. We have counting boxes. Important to have counting math books, pattern books, color books, anything that is about quantities and qualities for math here. We have puzzles, we have games, we have letter games so that our students can use any of these manipulatives to make letters and numbers. Down below, we have our manipulatives. We have your standard counting bears, dominoes, coins, dinosaurs, everything that really students need and love to play with, lots of pieces. We have nesting bears, we have large dinosaurs because we have students who absolutely love dinosaurs and they would just die for them. We have an abacus and shape matching game or a pattern game. So everything is organized in a way where students, again, are able to be independent. If they want to use multiple pieces, they can because they could easily get a matching game and the teddy bears, or they could get a big dinosaur and a small dinosaur. Really fosters independence and critical thinking without ever having to get the teacher. Right next to table toys is our art center, our science center. Again, small but mighty. We have everything labeled, what's inside the bins. So students know that if they're looking for something specific, they know what drawer to look for them in. And we have seasonal items. So it's fall right now. We have pretend leaves as well as real leaves. And we have gourds, acorns, squash in here. So students are really able to kind of manipulate things that are from the environment without ever really needing to leaving outside of the classroom. And the reason why all of these manipulatives are together is because this is where the bulk of the student time is going to be. Everyone loves manipulatives. They love knocking them down. They love pretend play. So we have them in front of three tables. Students could choose a cubby, bring it to the table. People aren't fighting. There's a lot of space. A lot of times students fight because they don't have space. So the three tables really allows for them to have their own personal space or even have co-play and not just side-by-side play. They could play together, they could build this imagination, they could count. And right next to this is our Wiki Sticks and our Legos. Part of the manipulatives, so near the manipulative table, but it's also more of a quiet play. So students could build letters with Legos in the writing center, or they could use the Wiki Sticks to build things that they want for the teddy bears. Again, location, everything's near together, accessibility. Set manipulatives in different centers that could be used together are together, and noise. It's going to be a little bit loud, so it's in the middle of the center of the classroom. I hope you enjoyed the tour.